The Philippine Health Department confirms the detection of the BA.2.12 sublineage of Omicron in a Finnish woman who arrived in the country last April 2. The woman was said to have visited a university in Quezon City before heading to Baguio City to attend seminars. Being fully vaccinated and asymptomatic, she didn't undergo routine quarantine. Symptoms such as headache and sore throat only showed 9 days after arriving in the country. A day later, she tested positive for COVID-19. The patient finished her 7-day isolation, has recovered, and returned to her country on April 21. The BA.2.12 sublineage was recently flagged by the United States Center for Disease Control and Prevention after an increase in COVID-19 cases were recorded in the U.S. 2 weeks ago. While preliminary data show that it can be associated to higher transmissibility, there is currently no evidence that it causes more severe disease.
Tuloy-tuloy ang kanilang pagkilala ng sub-variant na ito na BA.2.12 in terms of transmissibility. Kung ito ba ay mas mabilis kumalat, mas matulin.
Experts continue to call on the public to adhere to public health protocols, especially since, according to the Interior Department, the number of violations is alarming.
Muli po tayong mag-istrikto ang ating kapulisan sa pagpapatupad ng minimum public health standards. At tinatawag din natin ang mga LGUs, lalo na po ang mga barangay officials at barangay tanod, ang mga management ng commercial establishments, ang mga community leaders, ang mga campaign organizers na magtumulong sa pagpapatupad ng minimum public health standards.
Wearing face masks and other protocols remain vital, especially now that South Africa, where the variant of concern was first detected, is now observing a rise in infections.
Based on this graph, the new South African variants are now making an uptick, and it's a matter of time that the Philippines will follow, maybe 2 weeks or a month from now, as predicted by experts.
Amid the threat of emerging Omicron sublineages, an infectious disease expert urges the country to watch its borders.
Border control is critical at this point in time, or when we don't have yet these sub-variants, because past experience has taught us that with Omicron, it was able to penetrate the Philippines and it causes surge. Now we have a more transmissible sub-variant, and people from outside were carrying it, was able to bring it here.
Meanwhile, the World Health Organization says it has recorded the lowest number of COVID-related deaths globally last week, but it warns countries against further cuts in testing.
As many countries reduce testing, WHO is receiving less and less information about transmission and sequencing. This makes us increasingly blind to patterns of transmission and evolution. But this virus won't go away just because countries stop looking for it. It's still spreading, it's still changing, and it's still killing.
Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.